Hey guys, so really quick to the introduction. So on this video, see why I hate this eyeliner. It's already running, the e.l.f. gel eyeliner. So this look basically, it's just copper with burgundy and black. And towards the very end of the video, thank goodness, everything was practically done. The battery just, poof, just died on me. So if you guys like this look, which I hope you do, just keep watching. And as always, rate, be nice, subscribe. Let me know what you got like. This is a fairly new channel, and I just want to know your feedback and what would you would like for me to bring to you. Okay, then. Bye. So I'm going to start off with the highlighter, which is right underneath my eyebrow, my eyebrow bone, just the matte cream color. I'm going to start by patting it in. I do have tape on the side, which I think I have it too out on this eye. I don't normally use tape when I'm to create my shape when I'm doing my eyeshadow. Actually, I never have. I think this is the first time in my life that I've ever used this the tape. I normally just do it freehand. I'm gonna need more primer a little bit. And then if I need to fix anything or do any cleanups, I rather use the makeup wipes. But I also don't put my foundation on before I do my eye makeup, but I was kind of in a rush and I knew I wanted to do this, I wanted to do a video for this look. So that I can ensure that it's going to come out looking nice, I put the tape on there. The only reason why I put tape. So I'm patting it in. And then right underneath the highlight color, I'm going in with a taupe. This is from the L'Oreal Nude One palette. And I'm going in with 1, 2, 3, with the fourth color. And once I put that one in, I'm going in with the darker color right next to it. And I was looking for the names, but they're actually in, the names are in numbers. And I'm going to start from the inner corner out. And the reason is because I went for the lightest color, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, to show up on the inner corner the most. And I'm just blending that in. And then with the color next to it, which is a bit darker, I am going to go in it from the outer corner in. And you want to know something, guys? I'm looking at my other eye. I'm going to finish it off, but it was actually, so I went in with the first color with the fourth one, and then I went in with it with the four or five, with the sixth, this darker brown right there. And with the darker brown, I'm going to start in from the outer corner in so that it doesn't wash out the lighter color. So I actually want it to be lighter on the inside and darker on the outside. Then underneath that, I am going to go in with like a dark purple wine color from the Coastal Scents palette, their Revealed palette. And this is the palette that has like all the rose, the pinks in it, and purples. And I'm gonna go in it first with this. Once I more or less create the shape, I'm gonna darken it with this one right there. So I'm going in with the lighter, with the burgundy. I think it was with this brush. Oh no, it wasn't. I went in with a very small, thin brush. And if I remember, I went in it like this, as if there was a cut crease. All the way in towards the inner corner. So apparently I can't follow my eye shape on this eye, because if I do, it's actually not going to show up very well towards the inner corner. It's going to go in between the crease. And I'm going to go a little bit lower so I can match the other eye. You know, with the naked eye, if you look at both of my eyes, especially mostly without the makeup, they look fine. But when you're applying makeup in no half side of your face, of your body, is the same size. However, on mine, my body, one eye is definitely significantly bigger than the other. And it makes applying eye makeup kind of challenging. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with the, oh yeah, and on this eye, I actually blended it up, but it looks like I don't have to do much of that on this eye. Then I'm gonna go in with the darker color. And follow the same guideline and bringing it up though, feathering it. This Coastal Scents palette, although I haven't used all of the colors, so far the few colors that I've used, for the price, it's a very good palette, I must say. I don't have any negatives so far to say about it. The colors have very good payoff, very pigmented, and they last. This eye is so challenging for me. It literally is. But nobody tends to notice it unless I mention it. Which is all good. Because it doesn't always come out even. So nobody can really tell. So therefore, when I go out and I wear it, it looks good. Oh. My pencil fell. I mean my brush. So next, I am going to go in with this gold color here, and that is from the Shani Cosmetics palette. This one is 12-2, and I am going to go in with this gold color. Now this palette, the colors, they're like a creamy consistency. I think there's like two mattes, which is the black and the white. And I'm going to leave about 1/3 of the eye without any color, and I'm patting it in to get the most color payoff and little fallout, since I already have my foundation and concealer already in place. And as you can see, the color is actually going on very well. Okay, and then now on the outer corner, I'm just going to go in it with a matte black, with a very thin crease brush. I got this brush when I first started doing makeup many years ago, maybe 2008, 2009, off of eBay, and it was a set. It was my first brush, set of brushes for like $35. That's when I didn't know much about makeup. I have to make this a little longer. Didn't know much about the quality of brushes. That set is long gone. I think I've given the brushes away, thrown some out. And I kept the ones that I felt would be much more useful. 2008, guys, brush is still good. No complaints. Except that the paint chipped off of that. That's fine. As long as it's still productive. And I haven't found one quite like it to replace it either. Okay, anyway, so I'm going to go in at an angle on the outer corner. So you want to use the smallest brush as possible, but you want for it to be packed so that it can pick up the color. Very well, and then blend it in and pick up color as necessary. The other eye, I was gonna bring it in between the crease, but I knew that if I brought it in between the crease, it was going to disturb that purple burgundy color. And I didn't want it to either darken it, make it into a darker purple, because that's what black does to purple. And or I also didn't want it to hide it. So because I wanted to keep that in there, I just kept the black on the outer corner. I'm going to have to make this a little longer. I put some of that down. So that's not a gold, that's more like a copper. Yeah, that's the color. I put some of that damn copper over the black on my other eye. So I was gonna go in it in like a cut crease, but because of the shape of my eye, you can't really, really see it too much the way I had wanted it to be. Just I wanted a black cut crease And I didn't want to disturb the color already, especially since I'm gonna go out. And I didn't feel like having to fix it because I don't have enough time. So I'm actually, I'll see what I decide, whether I'm gonna do the same to this eye. In the meantime, let me fix this here. This brush tends to be better since this eye is bigger. All right, so I'm gonna take a very thin brush like this. This is a detailed brush. It's Morphe E30. And I'm going to go just a little bit in between the burgundy and the copper, like I did on the other eye. Not because I want to, but just to make it even with the other one. So this step is actually optional. This step is optional. All right, so at this point, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to leave it as is. I don't want to continue messing it up. I'm going to put on my gel eyeliner, which is from e.l.f., which I'm not particularly crazy about, but I couldn't find my other one, my felt tip or my other gel eyeliner. And the reason that I don't care for it too much is because it doesn't stay matte. It runs both on the inner corner and on the outer corner. So I don't care for it at all. I don't know if it costs $1 or $3, but it's not even worth $1 because if it's going to ruin your makeup throughout the day, it's not worth it. That damn chime, I don't know what it is that it's associated to, what app on my phone. Whenever it does something in there, whenever I get either something new or an update, I don't know what the heck it is. Yeah, anyway, this is gonna be one of those where I'm gonna add it, I'm gonna do a review on products I regret buying and you shouldn't buy. All right, so I believe my eyeliner is on correctly on the outer corner. With this tape, I can't really tell. I don't know if I've said it in the beginning of the video. I never use tape. This is actually my first time. But since I already applied my foundation and concealer and I didn't want any mess up on the side, I put the tape. First time I've ever used tape. I normally use makeup wipes. So that's why I put the tape. I also don't put my foundation on prior to my eyeshadow, but I wanted to do this video on this look for you guys, so to save time and because I'm going out, I did it first. And I'm using this mascara, it's Makeup Forever Smoky Extravagant. It's almost finished. I need to get another mascara. Another thing you're not going to see me do much is wear falsies. I'm the type of gal that I very, very, very seldom wear false eyelashes. If you see me wear false eyelashes, it's not because I'm going out. It's not because I feel that I need them. Only because I have some falsies. And I just want to use them. Normally, if I have good mascara, I can actually make my eyelashes look as if I'm wearing fake lashes. Because I literally take my time. This mascara is alright. It gives it a lot of length. I don't feel it gives me much volume. Let's see what it's gonna look like when I take off the tape. I hope to goodness it looks good. I'm gonna take it going up. Oh, it's okay. I'm impressed. I'm gonna leave it as is. Okay, so now on this side, I can put my highlighter. I'm using the Urban Decay Sin. It just came out. It is the bomb. I have all three of them. I'm going to do a review on it. Here's a swatch. It is beautiful, and I do mean beautiful. I love it. Damn, and I think I rubbed my... Alright, so next, I am going to put on my lip primer. The lip primer I'm going to use right now is by Bite. I like it because I have chapstick on. It says it's a lip treatment and it helps the long wear of your lipstick. I'm not sure too much about it as being a lip treatment. Like, it costs like $22, so if my lips are chapped, I'm not gonna go to it and use it as a lip treatment. I'm gonna put on some chapstick, okay? It lasts longer and it's cheaper. I can get chapstick for 99 cents on sale. Retail, the most expensive is what? EOS. It's like $3.99. I've seen it the most expensive, but you can get it on sale. Target, Walmart, CVS, Walgreens, Duane Reade. So I'm not gonna use this as a lip treatment. And I was deciding whether to use the matte Ruby Kisses, this pink right here, I don't have something to wipe it off if I don't like it. All of a sudden, for this look, I don't. I do. I have a roll of tissues here behind me in my book bag. I carry around with toilet paper. Yes, I do. And don't criticize, because I'll be the one with toilet paper when I go to a public toilet. And bitches be like underneath, is there toilet paper in your stall? I'm like, no. They say, okay. They're probably wondering. Or maybe they just say, hey, so she didn't use toilet paper. And or wondering, what am I using? Not me. I've got toilet paper and soap and a bottle of water, because it ain't make no sense for you to walk around with a bar of soap. Yep, a bar of soap. Just in case you need to wash your hands outside or the facility doesn't have soap. And you don't have water either, and maybe there's no water there. So I have a stash. Okay, now this is the lipstick I'm going to use. It is from Avon. It's called Cherry Jubilee. They do still carry this lipstick. However, the one that I have, this one right here, this one is so old. It's more than 3 years old. So the containers, they know Avon right now, their lipsticks that they're selling, I don't believe it's still this. They're always revamping their packaging, always. I'm not sure if it's still like this, but I'll tell you one thing. My lipstick is more than 4 years old, and it is a beautiful dark burgundy, and I love it. I love it. Actually more like a Merlot. I haven't seen any brand with this color. All right, I have to fix it. I'm gonna have to use a Q-tip, which I don't have here at my station. Applying this color is like applying a liquid matte lipstick, the ones that dry just matte, meaning that when you're applying it, you have to be careful, it's not forgiving. It has to be applied correctly or it's going to show. All right, so when I'm done, before I go out, I'll fix the Cupids bow and down here. Although the sales girl, because I just bought this lip primer, the sales girl did tell me that you can use this to fix the outline of your lips. Let's see if that's true. It's a bit on the shiny side, the lipstick. I don't think that's true. I think I'm just spreading it. This could use, Smashbox Matte Transformer.